There are many, many worlds in Dragon Adventures, and with a lot of new worlds being added lately, I should make a tutorial on what worlds are the best in Dragon Adventures. So I will be going after every point why you should need a world, or if it's worth it to get. So if we go to the teleport right here, before we spin the wheel actually, we gotta spin the wheel and look what we get, of course, because spin wheel of epicness is always nice. So we're gonna get some leaves. That was not worth the wait. That's kinda painful, you know? But anyways, if we go to the teleporter right here, or you click the worlds button right here on the bottom right, you can see all the worlds, and every single world you can unlock in a different way. So the first couple of worlds, the grassland, the jungle, the volcano, the tundra, ocean, and the desert, are worlds that you can unlock with coins, and each is more expensive. So the desert being the most expensive, and the grassland being the cheapest, which is completely free since you get it in the beginning. But anyways, those worlds are unlockable with coins, and then if we go to the fantasy, we have to unlock it with getting every single egg. The leisure, you have to be level 10 to get in, and you don't have to do anything except for level up, and for every world you gotta level up, of course. And for wasteland, we need to get toxic waste and concentrated potion, and a corrosive dragon, which is really hard to obtain. Well, not that hard anymore, you can find them anywhere in leisure if you really need them. And then the prehistoric world, the hardest world to unlock it. So I will be going over points in worlds that make them good and bad. So let's just start with the grassland. Okay, once we have joined the grassland world, which is the first world to unlock, you can get on a dragon real quickly by equipping them. We've got this really, not that small world, it's a pretty big world, but we've got this world with a fishing spot right here. But let's just start with the fishing spot. Every fishing spot is the same. Some worlds you can get different fish, but it's not really necessary. But of course, in the toxic wasteland, in the tundra, in the grassland, and of course in the fantasy world, we need to go there to be able to unlock the heart for the prehistoric world. We'll get that to that in a minute. But this world, why is this world good? Well, this is the world with the mobs that has the least amount of HP. So if we want to take a mother dragon or any dragon and you want to level them for the beginning, you can level them here really, really easily. And this world is just the world that you want to go for if you want to level, because it just, the mobs have such little HP, and you can just put an auto clicker or whatever, and you can basically just keep on clicking, and it's great for farming meat as well. So if you want a lot of meat to sell it for coins, I recommend you guys go to this world. But other than that, it's not really that great of a world, since the dragons you can get in this world are not really that good, and most of the people just end up deleting the worlds. And the way you can get eggs, of course, is the same in every world. You want to just go to these kind of mob spots, and I will be showing this in every single world. These kind of spots with the bushes or crystals and where mobs are, you just want to go to those if you are looking for eggs. But why is this world good? You can fish really easily. Everyone has access to the fishing spots. Finding eggs is pretty easy, since it's really they stand out. And then of course for getting meat or leveling up your dragon, it's a really good world. But other than that, it's not really that great. So let's just go to the next world, which is the jungle, and this world is a little more complicated. Okay, so we just joined the jungle world, which is a nice world, and the wandering trader spawned here, and of course you have a chance of this spawning in any world, and it's the same for every world every day. It can spawn in this world, but it can spawn in a different world as well. Why did I say this world is complicated? It's such an overgrown world, and it's such a hard world to get eggs in. And finding eggs is basically the same, but it's just really hard to see in this world. Just go to these spots with these mobs, and you'll find them eventually, which is it's nice. But is there a reason why you would want this world? Yes, you could get the eggs for the fantasy world, but other than that, it's a first PvP world, which means that you can kill other players in this world. So if you are looking for some PvP, and you want to PvP against some low level players, or you are a low level player and you still want to PvP, I recommend you go to this world. So what is this world good for? Basically only for the PvP and getting the jungle egg, and basically nothing else, since you can't do a lot in this world, which is kind of painful. But it's a really, really cheap world, so I do recommend you get this one just for the fantasy world, and if you want to PvP, of course. So let's go to the next world, which is the volcano world. And once we join this world, we are back in PvE, which means you can't PvP players anymore. But anyways, if you're looking to get the volcano egg, of course, look for these kind of spots. If you are looking to maybe hatch some dragons, or maybe Unlock the fantasy worlds. The dragons in this world are pretty good, not gonna lie. You can get some decent and strong dragons in this world. So if you're looking for a strong dragon, you can always hatch these eggs. But anyways, what is this world good for? Basically only for getting the eggs. It's not really a nice world that you can chill in. Of course you can chill if you want a egg, but it's not really a world that I would say like I would hang out in and just farm, because the items that you can get in here are not really that good, unless you're looking for the preset potions. The preset potions are different in any world, of course, but in this world it has some nice preset potions. Maybe that's a reason. If you like the preset potion, you could always just go in this world and get the preset potions, but other than that, I don't really know what you would use this world for. It looks cool, and it's getting a remodel, so this world is kind of worth getting, and this world will feature the Magmib, aka the Toothless, and the new meme, which is really cool. So I would get this world, but for now, this is not out yet, so this world is not really worth it yet. So it's a good world, but it's not really worth it. So anyways, let's go to the next world, which is the Thundra, and here it's getting interesting. So this world is really nice to have, since you need this world to unlock the prehistoric world, which means you gotta go and fish for hearts, and the fishing spots are located around the map. Here is one, the fishing spot. So if you want to fish for maybe the prehistoric, ice hearts, you can go here and fish for them. So make sure you get this world if you want to unlock the prehistoric world as well. If you want to get eggs, just go to these spots. They are basically the same in every world. Just go to those spots with the mobs, and I will just show them what they look like in every single world, so you guys know what to look for. But anyways, you want to look for those spots. And just to clarify, egg spawns are random. There is no tactic to get the eggs. There is no special way you can get them. You gotta just look for those spots and gotta be lucky. But why is this world worth it? It's a nice world to hang out in, and you can get snow, of course, which are really nice for getting special items, like maybe the snow walls, or not the snow walls, the snow trees, which are really, really cool. I really like this world, and I do hang out in this world sometimes to get some hearts and just give them away, of course. But is this world worth it getting? Yes, it is. I would recommend you guys get this world. So let's go to the next world, and we are at the teleporter already, and that is, of course, the ocean world. And this is a really fun world. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, this world is PvE, so you can't get damaged by other players. So for this world, I'm gonna equip a different dragon. And I'm thinking about equipping the Zintra, since that's a new dragon that can jump, of course. So this world is really fun because you have basically no gravity, which is so, so fun. You can mess around in this world, even though I look really ugly. You can just mess around in this world, and I just love the way you can jump around and have zero gravity. So if you want to have a good time and just have fun with friends and stuff, I do recommend you guys get this world, because it can be so much fun in this world, and you can just jump around and mess around, which is really, really fun. Of course, no prehistoric heart in here, so basically the only reason why you would get this world is for the egg, of course, and you can get them by looking for these spots, which is really nice. Just look for these spots and you will find eggs eventually, and this is one of the hardest worlds to see eggs in, because the render distance is kinda, it's a pain, since you can barely see anything. And this world is getting a redesign, of course, which is really nice, so you can see a little bit further. But I really like this world, and basically what you would get this world for is unlocking the fantasy world, of course, and you can just have loads of fun. So would you get this world? Is it worth it? Definitely yes. I have not have this much fun on any worlds, except for the prehistoric world, which we will get into soon. But this world is just really, really nice to have. So I recommend you guys get this world, of course. But anyways, let's get to the next world, which is the desert world. And this is the last world that you can unlock with coins. And as well, this is a world that is probably the biggest world in the entire map. In the entire game, I mean. So this world is just huge, and the desert egg is really hard to find. And I do recommend, if you just fly up, and you might not see it yet, but if you fly up, there's actually a sky island right here, and not a lot of people know about this. So if you're looking for these eggs, make sure to fly up as well, and you can find eggs right here as well. So what you are looking for, what you will be looking for, is just these kind of spots. Wait, let me just find one real quickly. these kind of spots where the mobs spawn and with the bushes, of course. So you wanna look for those and you'll find an egg eventually. So why would you get this map? So first of all, the dragons in this map are pretty decent. They look okay, so you can get it for the dragons, of course. And of course, you can get this map for the egg to unlock the fantasy. There's no prehistoric hearts, but of course, with this world being the last one to unlock the fantasy world, it's really nice. Speaking of fantasy world, let's go there now. And of course, you gotta teleport to Tusk and you gotta be level 25 to do that, of course. So go to the lobby, click on this task, and you can just put the eggs and that you got by getting eggs in these worlds. So let's just go to fantasy. And this world is definitely a must-have. And you must have the other worlds to unlock this. So I recommend you get all those worlds. But this world is a world that a lot of players need. So why is that the Mother Dragon? You can get the Mother Dragon, which is the strongest dragon in the game currently, except for the Chronicus when it gets fixed. But the Mother Dragon is a dragon that you can unlock in this world, of course. But I do recommend you guys to maybe get it in Leisure when you reach level 10. So how can you get it? Of course, you can unlock eggs by just going to these pouches again. And I haven't found any eggs yet, which is kind of a bummer. But I didn't went looking for them, of course. But this world is a really cool world to hang out in. And I do recommend you guys look this world only for the Mother Dragon to unlock it. And of course, to get the prehistoric heart. So if you want to unlock the prehistoric world, you must have this world. So you gotta get the Heart of Fantasy. So in order to get the Heart of Fantasy, you can go to a fishing spot, of course, with any other heart of whatever. You can go to the fishing spot, there's one right here. Just go fish and make sure you get 25 of these hearts. So do you need this world? Yes, you do need this one. It's really necessary to get this one. Which brings us to the next world, and this is not a teleporter, I just noticed. Let's just reset character real quickly so you can go to the teleporter. But the next world is the Toxic Wasteland, and you do need this world because, like in the fantasy world, you need to unlock the Toxic Wasteland to get the Heart of Toxic, which is the last heart. So get 25 of those in the fishing spot. It's somewhere here in the middle, I am not entirely sure where. But it's somewhere here in the middle, just look for the fishing spot. And make sure to fish here for the Heart of Toxic. And then you can unlock the prehistoric world with the hearts, or at least. And then you need every single dragon, of course. But of course, you need every single dragon, so you need every single world to be able to get that, of course. But why is this world a must-have only for those hearts? Of course, you can get the Redidon in here, which is a decent dragon. But I do recommend you just get this world for the prehistoric world, since it looks cool. It's a nice world, but it's really a world that's not really necessary for anything else, except for getting eggs, maybe. So the way you can get eggs, actually, is by looking for these spots again. It's basically the same in every world. So look for these spots with the mobs and with the bushes or crystals, and you'll find an egg eventually. But anyways, let's go to the last world, which is the prehistoric world. And of course, we won't be going over the Leisure, since that's not really a world you unlock. You can get dragons in it, so I'm gonna just skip over this. And of course, in the lobby, it's a world that you don't really have to unlock, so I'm gonna skip over those. So the last world is the prehistoric world. So the prehistoric world is really necessary. So if you get a fast dragon, this world is really something else. So it has a kind of a story mode. It has some missions to unlock dragons, and of course, one of those dragons is the Tsukai, which is a nice dragon. You can unlock it by doing this quest, and it takes long. It takes at least 5 days to do this quest. So if you want that dragon, make sure to get this world and make sure to unlock it. Anyways, this dragon is necessary for if you want the Zentros, which is the newest event dragon. And if you want the dragon, I do recommend you guys get this world. It's hard to unlock, of course, but it's definitely worth it. And getting eggs is the same as in any other world, of course. You can get eggs by just going for these pouches, and I will get them really quickly. I will find a quick spot. Let me see right here. We've got these pouches, and we can find eggs by going to these pouches and with these mobs right here. Just go to those kind of spots, and of course, you can find eggs right there. So if you're looking for eggs, make sure you do that. But if you want the Zentros, you can go and donate some hearts, which I do recommend you guys do. So we can help each other out with getting these Zentros, of course. You can do it here for if the event is out. And So currently, I think Zentrosses are out. People keep donating hearts, of course, and you can get the Zentros. But make sure you donate some hearts and get the Zentros for yourself. So this world is really recommended for if you want some cool preset potions, if you want to level up your dragons, just such as in the Wasteland, it gives the most XP there, of course. But this world is just recommended to have just for everything, single thing you unlock, because you unlock so much. So make sure you unlock this world, since you really need this world, since it is so much fun to unlock everything in this world. So if you're looking for just fun, make sure to unlock this world. But anyways, we went over every single world, of course, except for the leisure and the lobby, of course, but those really are just random tree. Hello? Yeah, that's a flying tree. You might want to fix that, but this world is really recommended for if you just want to have fun. So make sure you unlock this world. It's really fun. But anyways, we went over every single world. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope I helped you guys out, of course. So anyways, I want to thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye for watching.